Example for solution of right spherical triangle, consider the following problem. Solve the right spherical triangle ABC given that small a 73 degrees, small b 62 degrees, and the right angle it is at C, the surface angle C equals 90 degrees. We construct the spherical right triangle. The right angle indicated by this small square is at C. So the two other surface angles are denoted by A and B. And the side opposite the surface angle B, denoted by small b, is given 62 degrees. The side opposite the surface angle A, denoted by small a, is also given and is equal to 73 degrees. The side opposite the right angle C, denoted by small c, is not given. And the two surface angles A and B are not given. And we place the five parts different from the right angle into the five equal parts of a circle. And we call them the circular parts. We place these parts of the right spherical triangle in the circular parts. And we start with small b, and we go in counterclockwise direction, but we skip the right angle C. We start with B, A, angle B, small c, and angle A. But this is not the mnemonic device that we will use for writing the equation using the Napier's rules. In the mnemonic device, the sides of the right spherical triangle that form the right angle C will be written as is. These are the sides A and B. These sides form the right angle C. And these two sides will remain as is in the mnemonic device. B as is. And A as is. And when we place the other three parts of the right triangle in the mnemonic device, we write the complement of H. Instead of A in the mnemonic device, we write the complement of A denoted by A prime. Instead of small letter C, we write the complement of small letter C in the mnemonic device written C prime. And instead of angle capital B in the mnemonic device, we write the complement of B denoted by B prime. Suppose we start with angle A. We start by finding the measure of the surface angle A. If we want to solve for the surface angle A, in the mnemonic device, we take A complement or A prime as the middle part. using the first Napier's rule, it says that the sine of the middle part A prime is equal to the product of the tangents of the adjacent parts. If A prime is the middle part, then B and C prime are the adjacent parts. And in the first Napier rule, we need the tangent of B. B is given 62 degrees. And tangent of complement of C or C prime. But C is not given. C is one of the unknowns that we have to find. Therefore, we cannot use the first Napier's rule to find angle A. Let us try using the second Napier's rule that says the sine of the middle part is equal to the product of the opposite parts. If we consider A prime as the middle part, then A and B prime are the opposite parts. And we need small a. Small a is given, but angle B is not also given. It is one of the unknowns that we have to find. Therefore, we cannot start by solving for angle A because we cannot use either of the two Napier's rule. So let us start by solving for angle small letter C, the side small letter C. If we solve for the side small letter C, in the mnemonic device, we take C prime as the middle part. If C prime is the middle part, then capital A prime and capital B prime are the adjacent parts, and A and B are the opposite parts. By using Napier's first rule, the sine of C prime is equal to the product of the tangents of the adjacent parts. But angles A and angles B, angles A and B are both unknown. So we cannot find the side small letter C using Napier's rule. We try to find the side small letter C by Napier's rule number 2 that says the sine of the middle part C prime is equal to the product of the cosines of the opposite parts. The opposite parts are A and B, and these parts are given. Thus, we can find the side small c using Napier's second rule. And we write that by Napier's rule number 2. The sine of C prime is equal to the product of the cosines of the adjacent parts. That is cosine of A multiplied by cosine of B. We have to remove complement from sine of C complement by using complement angle theorem that says the trigonometric function of an angle is equal to the cofunction of the complement of the angle. Thus, by that complement angle theorem, sine of C complement is equal to the cofunction of sine cosine of the complement of C, denoted by C prime, complement of the complement of C. And the complement of C is C. That is, C and C prime are complement of each other. Equals cosine of A multiplied by cosine of B. Hence, from this equation, C is equal to, we take the shift cosine of both sides, and the left hand left-hand side simplifies to sin. The right-hand side is shift or inverse cosine. Cosine of A times cosine of B. We now substitute the given A 73 degrees and B 62 degrees. Hence, C equals shift cosine of A. A is 73 degrees multiplied by cosine of B, 62 degrees. And use your calculator that should be in degree mode to calculate this expression. We start with shift cosine of cosine 73 degrees, cosine of 73 degrees, multiply by cosine of 62 degrees. And you should get 82.110. You should get 82.110.663.24. 248.75651. Now, that answer is in degrees, and we will write our answer in degrees, minutes, and seconds. You take the whole number part of this decimal number. The whole number part is 82. That's 82 degrees. And from your calculator, you subtract 82 from the decimal number in your calculator, minus 82. And you should get the decimal number 0.110666324875651. And that decimal number is in degree. To convert that to minutes, we multiply that decimal number in your calculator by 60, because we know from your plain trigonometry that 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes. So in your calculator, multiply the decimal number by 60, and you should get 6.639795 69 79 49252 539131 31. And this decimal number is in minutes. Again, we take the whole number part of this decimal number, which is 6, and in the answer we write 6 minutes. And in your calculator, from your calculator, you subtract 6 minus 6. You should get the decimal number 0.639794925391. And that decimal number is in minutes. To convert that decimal number to seconds, we multiply that decimal number by 60, because 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Thus, the decimal number in your calculator multiply by 60. and you should get 38.387. It's a non-repeating, non-terminating decimal number. Now, this decimal number is in seconds, and we round it off now to whole number. After the decimal point, you round off the digit after the decimal point. And that digit is 3. And the if the number to be rounded off is 5 or more, we add 1 to the preceding digit. But since the number to be rounded off 3 is less than 5, we do not add 1 to the preceding digit. And this decimal round number rounded off to 38. In the answer, we write 38 seconds. Hence, the side opposite the right angle C is denoted by small letter C is 82 degrees, 6 minutes, 38 seconds. Now, suppose we find now the surface angle A, and within this mnemonic device, we take A prime as the middle part. By using Napier's rule number 1, the sine of capital A prime is equal to the product of the tangents of the adjacent parts. B and C prime are the parts adjacent to capital A prime, and B is given, and we just found the value of small letter C. Therefore, we can use Napier's rule number 1 to find the surface angle capital A. We now write the equation from which we can solve for the surface angle capital A using Napier's rule number 1 that says the sine of the middle part A prime, we write sine of capital A prime is equal to the product of the tangents of the adjacent parts, tangent of B times the tangent of small c prime. And we have to remove the complement angles from this equation using the complement angle theorem that says that the trigonometric function of an angle is equal to the cofunction of the complement of the angle. Hence, the sine of the complement of A is equal to the cofunction of sine, which is cosine. And the complement of the complement of A is A, that is A, angle A. And the complement of A denoted by A prime are complementary angles. A and A prime are are complementary angles. Thus, the complement of A prime is A. Is equal to tangent B, we apply the complement angle theorem to this tangent of C prime. Tangent of small c prime equals cofunction of tangent, which is cotangent. And the complement of c prime is c, small letter c. And we have cosine of A equals tangent of B. We use a trigonometric identity for cotangent c, because we do not have the function cotangent in scientific calculator. And one of the 8 basic trigonometric identities is for the reciprocal of tangent, which is equal to cotangent. Or cotangent C is equal to reciprocal of tangent C written 1 over tangent C. 1 over tangent C. tangent small c equals reciprocal of tangent written 1 over tangent c. This identity is one of the reciprocal relations. And from this equation, we have cosine of A is equal to tangent B multiplied by 1 is tangent B. In the denominator, we have tangent C. And from this equation, we can now solve for A. We take the shape cosine of both sides. And the left-hand side simplifies to A equals shape cosine of tangent B over tangent C. And we now substitute the values for small b and small c. A now equals shape cosine of tangent of b. Small b is 62 degrees over tangent of tangent of small c. Small c we found earlier is 82 degrees, 6 minutes. And 38 seconds. Again, you get your scientific calculator to calculate the value of A. Your calculator should be in degree mode, sorry. We have shape cosine, press shape cosine or inverse cosine in your calculator. Tangent of 62 degrees. Divide by tangent of 82 degrees. Six minutes. And 38 seconds. And you should get 74.8931. The answer has many decimal numbers. The answer is actually a non-terminating, non-repeating decimal number. And this decimal number in your calculator is in degrees. And we will write the answer in degrees, minutes, and seconds. We take the whole number part of this decimal number, that is 74 degrees. Do not erase the answer from your calculator. From your calculator, you subtract 74 minus 74. And you should get 0.8931 9261. That decimal number is in degree. And we will convert that to minutes by multiplying that decimal number in your calculator by 60 minutes. Because 1 degree is 60 minutes. So the decimal number in your calculator, multiply that by 60 times 60. You should get 53.591. 53.591 5567. Again, the answer is a non-terminating decimal number. But I have written only few of the decimal numbers. And this decimal number in your calculator is in minutes. We take again the whole number part, 53. The whole number is 53, and that's 53 minutes. From your calculator, you subtract 53 minus 53. And you should get the decimal number 0.5915567. And that decimal number in your calculator is in minute. We will convert that to seconds by multiplying that decimal number by 60, because 1 minute equals 60 seconds. Now multiply that decimal number in your calculator by 60, multiply by 60. And you should get 35.493. 35.493. Now, this decimal number is in degrees. We will now round this off the whole number. After the decimal point, you round off the digit. Round off the digit after the decimal point. If the number or digit to be rounded up is 5 or more, you add 1 to the preceding digit. But the number to be dropped is 4 and it's less than 5. So we simply drop 4 and all the digits to its right. And we take 35 seconds. Hence, the surface angle opposite the given side small a is 74 degrees, 53 minutes, and 35 seconds. And the only part that is left unknown is angle B. If you want to find angle B, we take, in this mnemonic device, we take capital B prime as the middle part. And to find the angle B using Napier's rule, you can now use Napier's rule number 1, because the parts adjacent to capital B prime, small a and small c, are now known. Or you may use Napier's rule number 2 to find angle capital B, because the opposite parts, the parts opposite angle capital B, are also known. We have B given and we just found capital A. I will use Napier's rule number 2 to find angle capital B. But you may also use Napier's rule number 1 to find the angle capital B. We now write the equation from which we can solve for angle capital B. And in this mnemonic device, we take capital B prime as the middle part. And using Napier's rule number 2, it says that the sine of the middle part, capital B prime, sine of capital B prime, is equal to the product of the cosines of the opposite parts. These are the parts opposite capital B prime. And cosine of B multiply by cosine of capital A prime is equal to sine of capital B prime by Napier's rule number 2. Again, we have to remove the complement angles from this equation using complement angle theorem. And by complement angle theorem, the sine of complement of B is equal to the function of sine, which is cosine of the complement of B prime. The complement of B prime, or the complement of B is B. Equals cosine of small b. And by complement angle theorem again, cosine of A prime, or cosine of complement of A, equals the cofunction of sine, sorry, cofunction of cosine, which is sine. Sine of the complement of A prime, or the complement of A, which is A. And we take the shift cosine of both sides, the left side simplifies to B. And the right hand side, we have shift or inverse cosine of B multiplied by sine of A. Or capital B equals shift cosine of B. Cosine of B is given, and it's equal to 62 degrees multiplied by sine of A. We just found the measure of the surface angle A. It's equal to 74 degrees 53 minutes. 74 degrees 53 minutes and 35 seconds. Now we use our scientific calculator to find angle capital B. You get your scientific calculator and you solve with me. We have shift cosine of cosine of 62 degrees times the sine of 74 degrees ...53 minutes and 35 seconds. And you should get 63.04779. The answer is non-terminating decimal number. But this decimal number in your calculator, do not remove that number, is in degrees. And we write this answer in degrees, minutes, and seconds. First, we take the whole number part of this decimal number, which is 63, and that's 63 degrees. From your calculator, you subtract 63 from the decimal number in your calculator, and you should get 0.04779. 2656451, an ending decimal number. That decimal number in your calculator is in degree, and we convert that to minutes. by multiplying that decimal number by 60 minutes, because 1 degree is 60 minutes. So multiply that decimal number in your calculator by 60 times 60, and you should get 2.867. 2.867 5593. Again, this decimal number is non-terminating decimal number. It's also non-repeating. So this decimal number in minutes is an irrational number. And we take again the whole number part, which is 2 minutes. And in your calculator, you subtract 2 from the decimal number in your calculator, and you should get 0.8675593 8710. That decimal number is in minute, and we will convert that to seconds by multiplying that decimal number by 60, because 1 minute is 60 seconds. Hence, multiply that decimal number in your calculator by 60 times 60, and you should get 52.0535. An ending, non-repeating, non-terminating decimal number. This decimal number, 52.0535 in your calculator, is in seconds, and we round it off now to whole number. After the decimal point, you round off the digit after the decimal point. But this digit after the decimal point is less than 5. So we simply drop it and all the digits to its right, and we take 52 seconds. Now we have found all the unknown parts of the given right spherical triangle. As a way of checking, we verify the properties of spherical triangle. One of the properties says that the maximum value of a side is 180 degrees. Hence, the small a, small b, and small c should all be less than or equal to 180 degrees. Let us check. Small a is less than 180 degrees. Small b, given 62 degrees, is less than 180 degrees. And the small side C, which we computed, is 82 degrees, and it's less than 180 degrees. Another property of the spherical triangle says that the maximum value of a surface angle or included angle in a spherical triangle is 180 degrees. B is 63 degrees, and it's less than 180 degrees. Capital A is 74 degrees, and it's less than 180 degrees. Of course, the right angle C is 90 degrees, and it's less than 180 degrees. In the next lesson, we will take up, I will define oblique spherical triangle, and I will list down all the formulas that may be used for solving oblique spherical triangles. But for your practice, please try the following problem. Solve the right spherical triangle ABC, given that small a 50 degrees, small c 80 degrees, and the right angle is at the surface angle C. Please try it. And if you have question about the lesson today, you ask your question in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, Art Kalisan. Thank you.